special guest, Ladislas at DC is the executive chair of the Pan-African Business Forum and the newly appointed chairman of the African Network. Yes, the African News Service. You know, SAPA's going out and now it's a news service. Reuters, they're coming in with Reuters to have an African-based news service. And also, he's a candidate for the president of Benin. So, at this point, we'll allow Ladislas to come give us a few words.
I'll start with our tradition to say Mekwabo, Ndoberume, which means you are welcome and I greeted you in my language. I'm glad to be here because I'm part and parcel of people who are around us here. It is also a great to understand that I work with, as a chairman of the Pan-African Business Forum, who is the coalition for the reinforcement of investment for the continent. We drive policies to the continent to attract more investment to the continent. We happen to meet with our great friend, the country, who become our secretary general, who have had many reforms in that direction. And we are very satisfied with that. He is a very critics, analysis of anything the committee was doing. I must say thank you, company, for your great support for our organization. I'm sure with your research, you will know the great work we've done in the continent. But to talk about what we are dealing today, I'm proud to be around today. And I realize that the gender equality is working at heart today. The women are more enormous here. They are vocal, they are talking greatly here, while the men are timid. It means that the next generation, the year 2015 is a real year of the women. I come from Benin, a place where the greatest pattern of slavery has happened. I'm from the great house of Dagoma. The brother of my father is the head of our trap there called each year, he is the one who goes to Trinidad, Tobago, Brazil. And he told me that they didn't allow them to come and do ritual in America. Because most of the people took the Souza, who was in America. With that, they took many of the people, majority of people to Brazil, and the other part went to America, to the gate of no return from Benin. But it was good to understand that I'm going to be president. I'm going to be, since April 2016, I'll be swearing as the president of Benin. No doubt about it, but my thinking with the diaspora is that we need to look at one of the statements the Big Brother spoke about. The reparation. There's a lot of harm our continent have done to us. The people of our brother who went to those places, Trinidad, Tobago, America. And people with myself, we are making a decision, and I'm doing it today, and I'll do it in front of you. And I'll say, when I swear in on the 6th April 2016, I'll ask for forgiveness. For all the trouble we take you people through. We are going to ask, and I'll be on my knees, to know that it was not easy to be part of a conspiracy to allow our brothers to go to that path. And I'm starting from today to say sorry on behalf of you. To go further on, I'm deciding, and I spoke to some of our colleagues, they are also going for election. We are going to make a place, a special place in our country, whereby it belongs to you, you come and do whatever you want to do. As you know that money is not my problem in this continent today. It's a last point. We have the resources, we have the people, with the capacity, we have the resources to drive our own economy. So when you come in, we'll put the resources at your service. Right. What we need is to exchange our ideas, our mind together to grow our continent. We are in a real serious close to the new age of golden of our continent. We have the capacity. We have the people with the resources. And together with you guys, together with our brothers, we can change this pattern of this continent. And my presence here today is to tell you that together we can make it. It's not about President Barack Obama has been able to do it very well. He has proven to the world that coming from the descent of Africa, you can make a change. Coming to power, 6 weeks before coming to power, the economy was very down. Through fiscal reforms, you change the direction of the economy. You change the hope of the people of the country. You change the direction. It can only be from an African descent to do that. It has never happened in the history of our career. Taking a lead from Malcolm X, 1960, and become changing the first derogatory law in immigration in America, which is going to play a very great role into poverty alleviation in South America, in Africa, indirect resources for some of us. We must be bold to do that. You can only come from an African descendant to be so courageous to do that. To have a very decisive foreign policy, great as the one Barack Obama has been able to do, to deal with the extremists. It's not the person you provoke to jump with the gun, but he will use all means of at his disposal before he comes to the last decision of using force. You can only come from the African descent to do that. Because the skills of the negotiation has been a pattern of we coming from the African descent. I must tell you the good news is that your continent is ready and we are ready to share with you. Thank you.